conduct this, this as a policy that they should, as a form of saying to the people who buy, purchase their vehicles, they should check their tyres on a regular basis, but also it should be common sense to renew those tyres before 10 years has expired. And I'd just like to say to Francis that, as regards to the fire and rescue authorities, we will continue to support this campaign. I will give their support, and we will do and offer any assistance that we possibly can go forward.
I want to go on further, Speaker. Councillor Morris.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. I'm going to be quite quick about this. I would like to thank Francis and Roy for coming to the Council today. We're going to be supporting this motion fully. We'll also be supporting the Tyred Out campaign. No mother should ever have to lose a child under those appalling circumstances. And as I say, we'll be supporting the Tyred Out campaign until government listens. Thank you.
Thank you for your brevity, Councillor Morris. We'll move straight on to the vote. Anybody rushing through the door with the bell or anything like that? No. Okay, we'll move to the vote. Those for the amendment. For the motion.
Agreed.
Agreed. Is that unanimous?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. We're moving back in the agenda now to motion. Item 11, which is Councillor Anderson's motion on it's now called.
Impact to us as a community and an impact to us as a city. But then you have to look at it and say to yourself, okay, we can manage that, we can control that, we can deal with it in a different way. But again, comes a period when, whether it's our fire service, whether it's people that work in the public sector, the health service, they look to us to stand up and speak for them. And this is where we are with regards to the police and the funding cuts to the police, that I feel we are now at a position where it is a total failure of our responsibility if we don't challenge government and speak out about the precarious position we are at in relation to community policing and how the police look after us as a community of the people of Liverpool. And that's where we're at. I was a couple of months ago, about 4 months ago, I was at a function in one of the hotels in the city where a detective constable asked to speak to me privately at the function, and I said, yeah, of course you can. And he cried, he broke down in tears talking to me about the challenges that he felt the police were facing, and also about how his colleagues were dealing with the challenges that they faced. He told me that crimes are not getting fully investigated, that crimes are being left without having the resources to complete the investigation. They're getting parked, they're getting left as they're pulled to more investigations on what is deemed to be more serious. And then we've seen in the city over 1,000 police officers lost in our city. But much, much more than that, we're actually seeing community officers, community support officers, people that we would expect to be the eyes and ears for the police, report to them, talking to them about the situation in that locality, that community. And that's lost, as well as the cuts to our youth service, all of those where we have and did have people that would provide information and support working with the police. 1,000 police officers have been lost. Officers in the matrix, officers working in gun crime, officers working to try and deal with community safety. We've had over 50 gun discharges since January. Over 50. It's a 158% increase in gun discharges. We've had fatalities in the city. The reality is that it's going to get worse if we don't work with the police to highlight the concerns that we all feel on their behalf. And I'll just read you a statement, and it's in the motion, but I'll read it out, and it's not my statement. It's actually from the Chief Constable. And he says, in my professional opinion, I have never known a situation where Merseyside police officers have been pushed to the limit in dealing with everything we need to deal with to keep our communities safe. That's a cry for help. That's a cry to you and to me as leaders in your communities and in your wards, and also to us as leaders within this city, not just here in Liverpool, but across Merseyside. When Theresa May came for Armed Forces Day, I actually spoke to her at great length about a number of things. But I told her about my fear and my concerns about gun crime in Liverpool and how we're failing to deal with those issues. And I told her about the number of gun discharges, and they were around about 48 or something, or edging towards 50 when she was here at our forces day. And she asked me the question about my view as to why there's been an increase. And I told her, quite bluntly, it's because of your cuts to the police force, because of the cuts to the police service. That's what's caused it. Added to that is the fact that criminals who aren't getting policed, criminals who aren't getting monitored, criminals who aren't getting talked about by the community through and to community support officers, feel and know that they can actually not get detected as quick and as fast and as efficiently as they were before. And not only that, we've got young people in our city who are being groomed by all the criminals. Groomed by all the criminals who are allowing them and engaging them to actually use guns. To actually use guns, to actually pretend or pretend that they are better and bigger in the gang culture that exists in our city. And they're being used to actually transport goods, drugs, as they call them, goods across the city and across the city region. That's what's happening. This motion actually talks about it. We need to talk about it. And we need not be fearful of talking about it. Because in the past, we always were reluctant to talk about it. And I had conversations with chief constables previously who were fearful about trying to give a positive message about policing and the fact that we are managing. I'm sorry to say, we're at a junction now where we need to actually talk about us not managing. We actually need to say it loud and clear, and we need to say it to this government, you cannot cut the police any further or any more, because it's putting people, the public within this city, at risk. That's the real issue. Community safety is being challenged by the reduction in funding, and we've got to say enough is enough. Now, our MPs have raised it. Our MPs have had a meeting to discuss it with the Home Office. Unfortunately, they've had no success in talking to them or get the response to them from them that more resources will come. So I believe that it's our responsibility as a council, as leaders and of parties across the city region, that we need to come together to actually organise and mobilise a demonstration in support of our police, not to go out onto the streets just for the sake of it, but to stand up and be the voice of our police officers. The man who cried to me about not being able to do his job, the man who represents you, he represents me, he represents what's